Search remarketing is such an important thing, and I keep seeing people that just miss out on this one, and they are missing out on such a big opportunity. Doesn't matter if you are affiliates pushing your own traffic or you are the product owner, okay? So first of all, what is search remarketing? For those of you who don't know, search remarketing is basically chasing down someone who viewed your site or landing page. How you do that is by implementing a cookie. It's basically the same technology of when you log into your Facebook account or your Gmail account, and the computer basically, or the server, remembers your credentials and it logs you in automatically. So the cookie, you place a cookie inside someone's computer or browser, and when he enters your site or landing page, and after that, basically you can start showing him ads. Of course, taking this a step further, you can start segmenting the users according to what pages or how many times they've spent, pages they've seen inside your site, how many time that person browsed your site, and start showing different content, different pieces of content and tutorials, etc., to different segments and types of users. That's extremely important part of marketing, because as we know nowadays, people are not going to buy your product immediately, or at least most of them aren't. So what they're going to do is start researching your brand, see reviews about you, they want to see substitute products, maybe competitors, and only after when they finish the research and the discovery phase, they are going to enter your site and purchase something from you, okay? I wanna make sure that I don't forget, please make sure you like, subscribe, and share this video if you like it. I'm doing this content for free, okay? This would keep me motivated. Make sure you do that. Please, please, please share. Marketing knowledge should be free, okay? Two big things to start off with, and this is why I love search remarketing so much. First of all, as an affiliate, most of the times you will not be allowed to run a search brand or a branded keyword inside Google's search network. While you are an affiliate, you can do that for your own traffic. That's a big thing. You should negotiate it. And if you don't know how to negotiate your affiliate offers, I have a video just right for that. The second part is that sometimes your marketing budget, even as the product owner, just for the brand name, would run out. And search remarketing is basically a campaign that doesn't need to, like the budget there needs to be limitless, essentially. Okay, so we're gonna go through understanding how to utilize search remarketing to the fullest, okay? And we need to understand four things: creative, bidding, targeting, and content, okay? Those are the big four benefits search remarketing allows us, okay? So let's work on it one by one. Let's start digging in. The first one we're gonna talk about would be creatives, okay? So most of the campaigns I see, they don't even have search remarketing campaigns inside, and those who do have them are using the same creatives. That's such a poor use of the fact that you already know that that person knows who you are and already saw the creatives already for the first time. He entered your website and those creatives didn't make him want to purchase or leave his details, okay? So why present him with the same creative? Why not present him with some other option, maybe a promotion, a sale, a discount, something that creates urgency, maybe a countdown timer, a clock, maybe some other text that would just like appeal to him in a different way. Second thing would be bidding, okay? When we're search remarketing, we wanna make sure that we capture those users fast, okay? At all costs. Those users are at the end of the research and discovery loop. We wanna make sure we grab them at all costs. So if you are manually bidding, make sure you bid a lot more than you do at like the normal campaign, according to what you see on the platform, of course. And when you are automatically bidding, just make sure you set it to the top of the first page, or just increase your TCPA, which is a targeted CPA, basically. This is such an important thing, because you want to make sure that you appear always, you want to make sure that you appear first on top of your competitors, and just like outbid them, even in an exaggerated way, because those users are going to be such a high value users, such a high value conversion rate, and just like high value click. Third thing would be targeting. Okay, so when we're targeting cold traffic, and by the way, if you don't know what cold or warm traffic, I'm making another video about it, but in general, when someone just sees your ad for the first time, we might not be able to want to target really wide type of keywords that are not geographically limited, maybe, or just focus on our niche. For example, if you're running a campaign in the supplements or vitamin space, and your product is a gummy bear that has the product inside, you just want to make sure you buy keywords that are related specifically to gummy bears, and not just run a campaign that's super wide, or like has like wide ranged keywords with the word detox or weight loss, something like that. You want to make sure you buy the more long tailed, narrowed down version. For example, weight loss gummy bears, okay? But when you are running a search remarketing campaign, and we're talking about warm traffic that already entered your site, your advertorial, or your landing page, you want to make sure you buy those wide-ranged keywords. And why is that? Because when people enter the research and discovery phase, after they've already got into your site and got to know you, they might be searching for a wider range keyword. When they finish that phase, you want to make sure you just capture them, make them clients, make them want to purchase from you. And just for those types of users and traffic, you want to make sure you bid competitively. Okay, you want to get a wide range type of keywords, generic keywords, maybe your competitors that don't convert usually, you want to make sure that you appear there. The fourth and final thing we're going to talk about in this video would be the content. And this is such a big thing. And why? Because out of all of what I've talked about, you have the most control here, okay? This is your playground. This is where creativity reaches no limit, basically. Second, this is most likely where your competitors are missing out. So we've talked about aligning your ads with creatives, and with the fact that we already know that someone has watched or entered your site and brand. Amazing, great, but what happens after the click? You need to ask yourself, what content every type and segment of user, persona of user, needs to see. If he already bought, do you want to send him straight to the product page, or maybe you want to introduce him to some maybe a new product you have? Maybe you want to send him, he bought a certain product, he's looking for that certain product, but you want to expose him to a new product that you're selling. If he entered through a specific advertorial that you're pushing and didn't purchase, why not send them to a more aggressive advertorial, for example, maybe adding some promotion, something like that. So the game here would be just A-B testing and noticing the conversion rate, okay? I'm gonna give you guys two extremely important wolf tips to even improve your search remarketing campaigns even more. The first wolf tip would be never forgetting to exclude the search remarketing audience from the main search brand campaign. So if you have a campaign that has your brand keyword inside, make sure you exclude traffic from your site. If your search remarketing campaign includes the traffic from the last 30 days, you want to make sure you exclude that from the cold traffic, because you don't want to overlap, pay more, or end up with the system not serving your ads at all. The second wolf tip is going to be that if you have a lot of traffic coming into your site, you need to start tagging and segmenting according to user behavior, meaning people who got in and bought something should enter a different campaign called search remarketing purchasers or buyers, for example, okay? You want to make sure you segment into campaigns those segments of users because you want to present them with some other things. So people who didn't spend enough time inside your site, if you have tons of traffic coming in from like really cheap CPC types of platforms, you might want to segment those users and maybe take them out, exclude them from the campaigns, so you won't be spending tons of money, especially if you're doing like really wide range keywords. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Make sure you like and subscribe. This is why I love creating content for you guys. Just make sure you keep me motivated in doing that, because that takes me a lot of time, and you can do that by subscribing and sharing this channel and videos. Thank you so much.